In a previous video, I clipped twin and CPC cables to a wooden board and show you how to get it flat and with equal clipping distances. And I said I'd go on and do the bend of a twin and CPC cable. So we're going to put a nice smooth 90 degree bend in it. So in order to do that, we're going to use some of the skills we did before. So we've taken a piece of cable from college, might have come off a drum, it might be second hand. And we're going to do what we did in the other video to start with, and that's get it flat. Four fingers underneath, thumb on the top, and we're going to drag it against the surface. And we do this many times, as shown in the previous video, in order that we can get it flat to the surface. So as I pull it down there, if I was to hold it in those two positions, it's already really flat. So we're going to do that several times throughout the length of the cable. I'm not going to do such a long clipping distance this time. So I'm dragging it down as we go. My thumb gets warm. Remember, at your college, you might be wearing gloves. And then I'm going to start to put the bend in it. Right, so we're going to put the bend in it. This time it's eight fingers on the outside and two thumbs on the inside. So I'm going to take my fingers and I'm just going to pull a slight bend, trying to keep it flat. And then I move my fingers along a little bit, take my thumbs and I pull again. And I go a little bit further along. Pull again, and you can already see that we've started to make that bend, a nice smooth bend as well. So we'll go again, and once we've got it where we think we've worked it, we're just going to start pulling that bend round to 90 degrees. So we've started working it, and we can see how the inner radius there is nice and smooth, and that's starting to look like a 90 degree bend. We then have to go back to the technique we saw before, hold on to the cable across the bend and drag it down. Come this way, hold on to your bend, and you drag it down. And we're all about just getting a nice smooth bend to start with. Okay, I don't want it too tight. Okay, the bend is just about feel at this stage. So we feel for that bend. So when we're happy with our 90 degree bend, we can look at putting it into our job. In this case, we've got a light switch box that we're going to put it into. I'll take my side cutters, I'm going to shorten this cable down a little bit from the previous time we used it. Again, I've cut it, just gonna drag it again. Drag again. Now I can pop it into the box, making sure I don't scuff my cable. We go into the box and we go about a length of the box longer than it was. So the box length plus another box length there. So if we look now, we've got our cable pretty much into position. It's pretty flat and we're gonna use the same technique we did before about working out where our clips go. Well, from a previous video when we measured it, we measured from our straight edge to the center of the cable to be 19.5 centimeters or 195 millimeters. So we'll do the same again. We've got our position. We're gonna put our top clip in first using our 1 to 1.5 millimeter clips. Again, we saw that in our previous video. They're slightly big for 1 mm. And this is a 1 millimeter squared cable, but we'll get away with them. We're 19.5 to the center, which is approximately there. And now we've got to make a decision of where we're going to pin our cable. Now I like to pin it so our nails will run down the inside of the bend. So I'm going to put the clip this way around. And I want to go pretty much on the first straight part after the bend. So we've got a bend there and I'm on the first straight part. We said 19.5, which we're just about there, the center of the cable, and we're just after the bend. And I'm just gonna pin it. So I've not put that nail all the way in. And we can carry on with our technique now. Hold on to our bend, four fingers and a thumb, drag it down and into our box. So we should find that that's not too bad. Now we're gonna work out where the other one off the bend is. If we made the center of the bend here with a pencil mark, I want to be equidistant for the next clip. So the clip's going to go, let's go approximately there. Let's just have a little look. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Just pin it again in case I want to change my mind. Knock that one into position, hold on to it, drag away. It's lifted slightly because the clips themselves aren't fully down. So it has lifted slightly. That is a little bit of a concern, but we'll see what happens to it when the clips are driven in into position. So we come now down, we know where our last clip's gonna go, which is about 15 mil from our box. So again, 19.5 to the center of that cable, and 15 mil up, making sure the nail stays on the same side. So we're on the right-hand side for the nail. So if we look now, we've got our nails matching the same side, and I've said in a previous video that I like my clipping distance to be a maximum of 300, and I'll leave an eye above my head. I'll leave a link to a video where I talk about clipping distances. So I'm going to measure this gap, and that gap is 390 or 39. So I'm going to need to half that. So we know half of 40 is 20, and then obviously we've got to come back another half. So we want this to be 19 and a half. Put a pencil mark on it just so you can see it. So 19 and a half from clip to clip. Let's check it this way. Clip to clip, 19 and a half. Okay, so that's in the correct position. And what we're gonna do is come off our hard edge here, and it should be 19 and a half, and it is. So we should be clipping just there. Now we'll make sure we get it around the right way. So the nail needs to come my side and pop that into there. And then just pin it again. So why we pin it is when we look down it, so when we come round and look down this cable, we're hopefully trying to see that it's straight. If it isn't, we can wiggle out the clips and move it so it is straight. We're going to need one more clip just to hold this out of the way. So I'm just going to pop one just in there and then cut off my cable. Just so when I put my board away at the end of the lesson, it doesn't get in anyone's way. So let's have one more look down the run of it. So I'm looking down the run. It looks dead straight and dead flat. So that's dead flat to the surface. And we can now knock these in. Remember to hold your hammer down at this end, not at this end. And we're looking just to hit the top of the nail and not miss and hit the cable. The one to be careful of is always the one down here near our box. Just take a little bit of time. And there we have it. We've got a equidistant clipping distances. It's flat to the surface. Our bend is flat as we can get it as we come round, with a nice smooth radius just there on the cable. Now, if you want to see how I work out bending radiuses of cables, check out the video just there.